Alrighty, hello guys, welcome your faces back to another Stormworks Search and Destroy video. Today we are continuing on with this boat right here, and as you guys can see, we are just floating around in the ocean. Now, there is a reason to this. We actually need a little bit more money. We have a 20 grand budget, and we are going to be spending quite a bit more than 20 grand, because missiles actually cost quite a lot of money. So, we're going to have to go find a box, and then we're going to drive back, and we are going to go ahead and start building our missile launcher. Now, I'm not entirely sure how this is going to go, so, yeah. Anyway, let's get on with it, shall we? Okie dokie, so first things first, I think the easiest and best way of getting some money is actually going to the hospital island, which is right there. And usually there are some boxes on the hospital island, so that's what we're going to work on getting. Hopefully all goes well. Alright, how's our fuel situation? So if we go this speed, our fuel situation is actually a-okay. I'm not full throttle though, so that's a thing. Alright, so while we're actually going this way, if you guys are actually enjoying this series, please leave a like on the video down below. It'll help me out massively. And if you guys haven't subscribed already, maybe consider subscribing. That'll also help me out a lot too. But anyway, we're going to go ahead and park this thing up right about here. Let's go ahead and park ourselves in. There we go. We do have a reverse, don't you worry. We've sort of beached ourselves, but that's fine. Go ahead and turn these off, and that'll be a-okay. Hopefully, when we come back to our boat, it will still be able to get off the beach. Maybe. And there we go. All right, collect loot, 7,500. That should be enough to actually make some missiles and stuff, so let's go back. Turns out, now the budget is actually, well, we're going to go over budget, to be fair. But that's fine. That's okay. The idea was to actually build a boat that would actually work, and that's it. But I was trying to do it within money constraints because I thought that'd be interesting. But considering each missile is going to cost us a few grand, probably like 2 grand, I think that's a little bit too much, to be fair. But anyway, let's go ahead and get back on our boat. We'll actually head out and get back to the base and start building. Here we go. Yes, okay, so that actually works. That's good. It's a good test, actually. And we should be able to go backwards. There we go. Awesome. We need those catalytic converters back as well. That'd be awesome. All right, here we go. Go forwards. Okay, amazing. And we'll take ourselves back over to our little base. And we'll get building. Yeah. Okie dokie. So I made it back. And now essentially all we got to do is we got to start building our missile deployment system thingamabobby. So how is this going to work? Well, we need to start off with pivot. Okay, pivots don't actually cost that much money. They only cost 40. All right, in the grand scheme of things, 40, not a lot. So we're going to go ahead and have that just like that. We're actually going to go and bring this around to this side, just so we can head start that side. And that's actually pretty good. We're also going to go ahead and put this on here as well. And we're also going to put this on here as well, because we can. Okay, excellent. And now we actually need to start the building process, and this is where things are going to get kind of interesting and maybe even a little bit difficult. So we're going to go ahead and start off by attaching two pieces to the front of this. We're also going to go ahead and add some pieces to the rear of it as well. And in fact, actually, this piece right here is going to go like this, just in case we need to aim it up. That bit actually won't collide with the pivot down below, which is great. So there we go. That bit is all sorted just like this. I do feel like it all needs to be painted in a different color, but for now, we'll leave it as is. Okie dokie. I'm also going to go ahead and say that I feel like we should actually have... that's going to have to stay like that. 3 missiles in a row. We'll then have 3 missiles above that as well that'll hopefully all work. So if we get hard points, we should be able to just whack these on the back end like this. 1, 2, 3. There we go. And that is where the rockets will be attached to. Is that okay? I think so. Okie dokie. So since they are going to be 1x1s, we're actually going to go ahead and seal this off like this. We're obviously going to do the same thing on the other side, and we're going to go ahead and do this as well, just because we can. So that's all a-okay. Should obviously work, which would be great. And yeah, I guess that's all fine. We'll then actually do this, and this. Oh, it's going to have to be quite tall, isn't it, if we're going to do that? Maybe we do actually just have 3. Maybe we only have 3 rockets. Is that too little? Is that not enough? I'm not sure. I don't know. Actually, you know what? Let's actually build a missile first. So let's go ahead and grab this. We'll go ahead and put it there. In fact, we'll put it here. We'll go ahead and put one above. And yeah. Okay, so now we need a hard point. which is going to be one of these ones. Okie dokie, excellent. And actually, yeah, it only has to go there. Good. So let's say we've got that. Okay, I now need to figure out how to build the missile again because I won't be able to remember, but I'm sure it'll be fine. Right, so rocket. I think if we type in rocket, that's going to be A-okay. So we're going to have one of these. And the way it's going to have to work is it's going to have to be pointed this way. So we're actually going to go ahead and do this just to make sure that I do it properly. So we're going to do that. We're then going to go ahead and grab this piece and put it there. Okay, excellent. We're then going to grab this piece and put it on the back. Okay, because that's part of the missile. We're then going to grab a warhead, which is going to be a tiny one, a small one like this. And then we're going to add a radar, which is going to go on the front of that. And I believe that is literally all we need. I think that's all we need anyway. Right. So let's say that is all we need. Let's go ahead and grab all of these. Go ahead and copy them. Move this one over one and paste it in. And there we go. So let's say we've got three missiles. Three missiles. Yeah. Why not? That seems pretty good. Pretty legitimate. Very nice. Then we're actually going to go ahead and make the back end of this look a little bit better. So that's going to go in there like that. We'll also do this. And honestly, we're just going to seal it up. There we go. Okie dokie. Go ahead and grab this guy. Put it on there properly if we can. Okay, excellent. And I feel like we should seal up the top as well. But honestly, I feel like we might have some problems. So that might be an issue. But let's go ahead and do this. Bam, like that. Good. And should we seal it up? Let's seal it up. Okay, so we're going to seal it with three missiles in it. Just three. This could be a test to see how well this will work. Or it could just be how it's going to be. But there you go. So let's say we got three missiles. We're going to go ahead and put this on the top like this. Okay, excellent. I think we might even put a door on the front of it, but we'll see. We'll leave it like this for now. And we'll see if it works, I guess. Why not? Let's try it. All right, so how are we going to do this? We're going to go ahead and get ourselves some buttons, and we're going to try and figure it out that way. In fact, actually, we'll get a helm, and we'll figure it out like this. So we'll put the helm off to the side. It's going to go right there. Okay, good. In fact, we're going to point it towards it, because then we'll be able to see it and stuff. So I actually put it right there. Good. And we'll connect it all up. So all of these need connecting to each other. Okay, so each missile actually needs connecting to each other. We then need to connect this to this to this to this. That then connects to that. Okay, excellent. Whoa, redo. These guys all need a fuse. So they're going to be 15. Good. 15, please. Good. And 15 as well. There we go. Excellent. So all that's good. We're going to go ahead and make left and right sticky on this thing. There we go. Left, right. There we go. Excellent. And we're going to connect that up. So left and right. This one. Go to there. Up and down needs to be sticky as well. Up, down. Up, down. Okay. Excellent. And that's all fine, I guess. First missile to be launched will be this one. Second one will be the middle one. Third one will be the other one. Sorry, not release. We need it to be on launch. Launch. Okay, very good. This is going to connect to this and this and also that. Same with this one. There, there, and there. And then same with this one. There, there, and there. Okay. That's fine and dandy. I think that's all A-okay. We then have to attach this to there. This to there. And this to there. And that's it. I think that's it. Is that it? Is that all we need? Is that legitimately all we need? I'm not sure. Okie dokie. So, this is it. That is our missile launcher. I know it's not the best, but honestly, it's for testing right now anyway, so that's all A-okay. Anyway, turn all these things on. There we go. Awesome. Go upstairs. Yep. And go. We're just going to drive out of here. Okay. Excellent. I wish it wasn't so wavy for testing, but that's fine. We're going to drive over towards that, which is actually a civilian boat that is on fire, and we're going to blow it up. This doesn't seem like a good idea, but we're going to see if our missiles work as well, I guess. So there is a positive. And there we go. Okay, so I think we're actually close enough. Let's go ahead and stop ourselves from moving. We'll also go sideways, just so that we have the best chance of hitting our target. Oh, no. Okay, so this goes this way, and aim it that way. There we go. Okay, is that kind of the right direction? No, a bit more. Bit more. Okay, there we go, like this. And then I guess we just fire them. We're going to explode. I know this isn't going to go well. Okay, so it misses the target by a million miles, but it doesn't explode on shot. Whoa! There we go. Yeah, okay. So The missiles need editing, obviously, because they're just going up in the sky. But, with that being said, that's kind of promising. Where are they? That one's going to land. Boop. Plop. Is there a third one? Where's the third one? I don't know. They all landed in sort of the right area. So that's okay. That's pretty good. Okie dokie. So I guess this is somewhat cheating, but not really, because we're just testing out the rockets. Obviously, it takes a little while to actually make these rockets work properly. And I feel like we are going to struggle, but if we test it out in this little setting, I think we'll be okay, because now we can go in third person and we can fire them. It's kind of promising. That's very promising. I don't know where that one went, but the others were actually very, very promising, actually. Okay, so essentially what I did is I actually selected these guys. I selected it to static because I figured that makes sense. Pitch angle I've left as is, and then I've changed these to 0.08 because reasons. These guys are all the same as they were. These guys, I haven't actually changed. We're going to go for a radar-guided missile. We go for that on all of them. Radar-guided missile. And again, radar-guided missile. Very good. We're then going to go to these guys, and we'll give them a little bit more input. There we go. We'll give them a little bit more. There we go. Influence, I should say. There we go. And that's all good. And we're also going to make them a little bit faster as well. We're going to go to 60%, which I guess is fine. So 60%. There we go. Spawn it in. Let's see if this works. Okie dokie. If everybody's ready, let's go. Fire the first one. Yep. There it goes. Oh, it just missed. Fire the second one. I feel like they're trying to hit it, but they're... The third one isn't trying to hit it. So the first two try, the third one just doesn't. So whichever one the third one is, this one doesn't try. So why is this one different to the rest? Ah, wait. Delete these guys. Hold on. That's why, because this one's different. Right, okay, so let's go ahead and grab this. There we go, grab that. Cut it. Flip it, press U, paste it, merge it, and then we'll be good. All right, so erase that, merge this to this, and then we need to put it all back, essentially. So let's do all of that, and then this as well, bam, bam. And our missile launcher should work, I guess. However, there is still more issues. I'm going to give this 100% influence, 100% influence, and 100% influence. And we'll see if that works. I don't know whether it'll help or hinder, but we'll see. All right, so if everybody's ready, let's go ahead and turn this to the side. Go ahead and press 1. 2. Okay, that one went underwater. 3. We still got issues with that one. What are you doing? Oh, I think it's the rudders as well. Even the thing on the back's probably the other way around. So let's check that really quickly. Hold on, it's probably under here. There we go. And as you guys can see, yep, this one's the wrong way around as well. So the third one was always going to go the wrong way. That's unfortunate. Paste it in. There we go. Delete that one. Merge them together. And there we go. So that's why we did some testing that wasn't in the career mode. It's because it would have went badly. There we go. We'd have to go in and out, in and out, in and out. And it just wastes money, time, stuff. Anyway, this is good. This is excellent. So now it means... It will work. All three missiles should fire in the right direction and be able to take out our enemy. It also means that we can actually work on changing how this looks. Because at the minute, I would say this looks pretty ugly, but we're going to turn it to the side. Press 1. Yeah, that missed. That missed. That also missed. Why? Why did they miss? Why? Try again. Go. Missed. It hit it. Okay, so we just have to add a little bit of angle to this to like lift it up a little bit, and then we're good. All right, cool. Good. And that's how much damage they do. Quite a lot, to be fair. So, yeah, there is a failure rate on them, but I think that's okay. That's quite fine by me. I don't know about adding more missiles. I feel like I should add 2 more, like, to the side of this. I feel like I should add 2 more to the side of this. Maybe. Should I? I don't know. I might leave it as is for right now. Right, I'm going to go ahead and paint it darker colors. We're actually going to go ahead and paint around the edge like this. There we go. I'm going to do this on both sides. And we're also going to paint the inside this color. Bam, 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 bam. We're then going to actually jug the inside this color, and this color. There we go. And that all looks okay in there. Yeah, okay, that's actually excellent. So the inside is actually painted. We're going to do the outside edge just all the way around the outside. There we go. And that looks pretty nice. And we're actually going to give it like a little bit of a red thing, like a line. There we go. So this is going to be like our red line. So we're just going to use it because why not? A little red line can't harm anything. Pretty good. It looks weird. I know it looks weird, but it's what we've got. So there you go. I am going to try it on the move now. So W and S is going to be on sticky. And we're going to try it on the move. So spawn this in. We're going to get driving, and then we're going to try it out. We also need a stability system on this thing too, so we'll figure that out too. But for now, let's go ahead and go downstairs. I don't know why I'm able to use it without this stuff activated, but I don't know. So yeah, let's go ahead and turn these on. Press 1, press 2, sorry, just 1. Throttle forwards, and now we are moving. Hey, excellent. Excelente! Okay, so close this up. We don't want to fall down there. Close this up as well. Turn this to the side. Lift it up slightly. Okay. Unfortunately, I didn't make it on a velocity pivot, so that's all it can do. But that's all right. Let's go ahead and drive by. Drive by shooting. Sounds bad, actually. Go. Oh, it just missed. Oh, I missed by a mile. Turn. All right, so we figured out one of the problems we've got. We've definitely figured out one of the problems we've got. And 3. Yikes. Big yikes. Okay, so we figured out that they do actually need to be fired in the right direction. So, I mean, that's obviously a good thing to figure out. The other thing that I do want to try and figure out as well is if we spawn this in again, can I fire them, like, up and over? Can I do that? I'm not sure if I can do that. Let's test it. Okay, so we'll do this. Open up this door. We'll actually turn ourselves just to the side, I guess. Let's just turn these on. Bam, bam, bam. Go back upstairs. Turn ourselves sideways. Like this. Okie dokie. We're going to put ourselves facing directly towards it. And I guess it might be too close to even try this, but let's do this. And I guess fire? Way too high. It just goes up. It just goes up. What if we lower it down a bit? Again, it just goes up. And again, it just goes up. So all of them just went up into the sky, and that's it. That's all they do. Sag. Big, big sag. Okay, but they do work. They explode, and our little launcher doesn't look too ugly. It looks quite ugly, but not super, super ugly. So I think we passed that. I think it's a pass. Maybe. Maybe. All right, well, the last thing I want to do today is I'm actually going to go ahead and paint this bit like this. We're going to go and paint this bit as well. We're going to paint that bit. And we're going to go ahead and paint all of this. Purely because we can. We're then going to go to the front. We need to grab one of these. Go from there to there. Go ahead and copy it. Move it backwards. There we go. Turn it around. Press U. Paste it there. Bam. Move it to this side. Press U. Paste it there. Merge it in. And merge it in. That's it. That is it. Excellent. So there are a few things that we still need to do. It needs an anchor. It might need a gun on the front if you guys decide whether that's a good thing or a bad thing. And yeah, that's it. We need an interior as well. We actually need equipment in here and maybe some extra seats. And I think that'll be good for us. I think that will actually be very good for us. I like it. I might make this a 5-shot as well, but we'll see. Anyway, for right now, I'm going to go ahead and say thank you guys very much for watching. I hope you guys have enjoyed this building series. I know it hasn't been very long, and I know that some of the things, I mean this, I feel like it should look nicer, and I feel like it should work a little bit better, but I was going to say, but it works enough. Don't know if it does. See, they all missed, but they all were very close. So is that okay? I don't know. We might have to work on this system, but that's fine. Anyway, the reason this had electricity, by the way, as well, is because the hard points themselves have electricity. And when they've actually been fired, this thing can't be moved. Unless we go downstairs and do the breaker. So that's an interesting thing. But anyway, for right now, I'm going to go ahead and say thank you guys very much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed it. See you in the next one. Goodbye.